Hi, welcome to the kitchen of Lindy Says. I'm Lindy. Today we're going to make some fresh ricotta, so let's get cooking. Okay, we're going to start with some milk, whole milk, 6 cups, 2 cups of heavy cream. Try not to get super ultra pasteurized. You want it to just be regular cream, organic's best. The juice of a half a lemon, which is about 2 tablespoons. 1 tablespoon of white wine vinegar. I'm using white balsamic vinegar. And 1 teaspoon of kosher salt. Not a lot of ingredients for such good taste. You're also going to need a heavy pan and a nice little setup like this. I have the cheesecloth in between 2 colanders. That's just my preferred method of straining things so that the cheesecloth doesn't fall in. And I've set it on top of a deep, my KitchenAid, deep bowl so that when I start moving the curds over to the sieve, they'll be able to drain into the bowl. So let's get started. Turn on our stovetop. Going with a medium heat. Pouring the milk. Pour in the cream. And we're gonna let that heat up to almost a boil. I am not gonna let it go to a full boil. I'm gonna wait until it just has a bunch of bubbles around the outside. You could use a thermometer. The temperature should be between 180 and 200 degrees. And that's when the magic's gonna happen. So now would be a good time to add our salt. And we're going to stir this occasionally just to keep it from scorching on the bottom. Okay, hope you can see this. It's just starting to bubble up around the edges. I'm going to let it bubble just a little bit more before I add my acids. Okay, you probably can't see this, but it's at 193 degrees. It's just simmering around the edge. Just getting that little simmer thing going. So now I'm going to turn off the heat. I'm going to add the lemon juice and the vinegar. I'm going to stir that gently. And now I'm going to let it sit and let the curds in the whey separate. We're going to give it about 2 minutes. Okay, so this is what I'm looking for. See this nice thick? I don't want big curdles because I'm going to use it to spread it as a cheese. So this is looking really nice. And I am going to start spooning it into my cheesecloth to let it drain. Oh, hell, that looks like a lot of work. I think I'll just pour it in. But I can't film that because I only have two hands. I'll be right back. Okay, so I poured it in. Now it's just draining. You can hear it. Tinkle, tinkle, tinkle. And we'll go for about 25 minutes and just let it drain out. Okay, this is starting to get really, really thick.